then it comes to मॉडल इवेल्युएशन, मॉडल प्रेजेंटेशन एंड स्टेटिस्टिक्स के अलावा हमने देखा व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन लर्निंग एंड डिजाइनिंग एंड देन वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन अबाउट दी टेस्टिंग एज वेल एज ट्रेनिंग. वी हैव सीन द डिफरेंस बिटवीन लर्निंग एंड डिजाइनिंग एंड देन वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन द डिफरेंस बिटवीन ट्रेनिंग एंड टेस्टिंग डेटा. सो ओवरऑल वी कुड सी दैट इन इन ऑल द केसेस वन थिंग विच इज वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट इज दी डेटा. ऑब्वियसली वेन इट कम्स द स्टेटिस्टिक्स कम्स इट इज गोइंग टू बी इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन डेटा. सो टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम ऑफ दी टेक्निक्स ऑफ डेटा बेस्ड मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम बिकॉज वी नीड टू ऑर्गेनाइज दिस डेटा इन अ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट वे, इन अ वेरी नाइस वे, सो दैट इट कुड बी प्रोसेस्ड, presented and it can be useful for model evaluation, model presentation. So in this database is going to be very much important and henceforth today we are going to see about the database, some of the few database techniques that have been used for the machine learning. So today we are going to learn the types of database management system in case of machine learning. So one of the most crucial and critical component in machine learning projects is the database management system. With the help of this system, large number of datas can be sorted and one can gain meaningful insight from them. So obviously the data which we collect or the database which we collect is not in an organized way. It is not in a proper manner. Hence it has to be sorted and can get a meaningful data from them. It should be sorted in such a way that we should get a meaningful way from them. So how it could be done? So we are going to see 10 ways of doing the management system. So out of that, first one is an Apache Cassandra. It is the open source and highly scalable no SQL database management system. It is designed to manage massive amount of data in a faster manner. This popular database is being used by GitHub. So you know what is GitHub, Netflix, Instagram, Reddit, and among the others. So this is one of the most popular database management system, that is Apache Cassandra. So Cassandra has an Hadoop integration with MapReduce support. So this is the feature that Cassandra has with itself. And Hadoop integration helps you to organize the data, organize a massive data in a very nice way. Now, what is the advantages of Apache Cassandra is that it has two advantages. One is the fault tolerance, and the other one is an elastic scalability. So what is fault tolerance is that in Cassandra, the data is automatically replicated to multiple nodes for fault tolerance. Also, a failed node can be replaced with no downtime. Clear cut is that due to the fault tolerance, there will be some nodes which will be failing. And in order to replace these failed nodes with a very quick succession is possible with the help of Apache Cassandra. Then second advantage is that it is having an elastic scalability. That is, Cassandra is designed with both read and write throughput and increased linearly as new machines were added. So it can be used for reading as well as writing. The throughput is nothing but the output to input ratio, and which increases linearly when you add new data to it. So that is called as the Apache Cassandra. Second is the Couchbase. We are going to see 10 database management systems today. Second one is on Couchbase. It is again an open source distributed. Then no SQL document-oriented engagement database. It exposes a fast key value store with managed cache for sub-millisecond data operations, purpose-built indexes for fast queries, and powerful query engine for the execution of SQL-like queries. So obviously, the Q language is very important as far as the database management is concerned. So Couchbase is again one of the open source distributed no SQL type of document-oriented management system. The advantages of this Couchbase is it is unified programming interface, That is, Couch database platform provides a simple, uniform and powerful application development APIs, that is the advanced programming interfacing across multiple programming languages, connectors and tools that make the building application simple and accelerate time to market for applications. Then the second advantage of the Couchbase is big data and SQL integration. So that includes built-in big data and SQL integration, which allows a user to leverage tools, processing capacity and data wherever it may reside. Then the third advantage is container and cloud deployments. So Couchbase supports all cloud platforms as well as varieties of container and virtualization technologies. So this is all about the database management system, and we have been studying the open source distributed database management system, which are no SQL document oriented management database systems. So this is completely the knowing about the database management system. So we have seen the Cassandra, and second one is now the Couchbase. We are going the third one, DynamoDB. This is the Amazon DynamoDB, which is full managed multi-region durable database with built-in security, backup and restore. These are all the features, and in memory caching for internet scale applications. This accessible database has been using by Lyft, Airbnb, Toyota, Samsung, and among the others. So different companies uses this database management system for machine learning. So in that they included like the big names like Toyota, Samsung, and others. The DynamoDB offers encryptions at rest, which eliminates the operational burden and complexity involved in protecting the sensitive data. Protecting the sensitive data. Now, what are the advantages of DynamoDB? It is high availability and durability, that it spreads the data and traffic for tables over sufficient number of servers to handle the throughput and storage requirements while maintaining consistent as well as fast performance. Then performance at scale, DynamoDB provides consistency as a single digit millisecond response time at any scale. Though DynamoDB global tables replicate the data across multiple AWS regions in order to provide fast and local access to data for globally distributed applications. So this is the third database management system. It is very nice because it has been mostly adopted by different companies like Toyota and Samsung. Has number of features including the traffic of the tables over sufficient number of servers, and has been maintaining consistency as well as in the fast performance. So this is about the DynamoDB. Fourth one is an Elasticsearch. You can search all these things on Google and you'll come to know about these database management systems that are used in the machine learning. Elasticsearch is the yet another database management system. So it is built on Apache Lucene and is distributed an open source search and analytics engine for all the types of data, including textual, numerical, geospatial, structured and unstructured data. In sabhi ke liye Elasticsearch use ho sakta hai. To aapke paas agar database manage karna hai aur wo bhi itni varieties of datas ke liye, to Elasticsearch is also one of the best options. It is a central component of Elastic Stack, which is a set of open source tool for data ingestions, enrichment, storage, analysis, and visualization. So in sabhi cheezon ke liye open source tool kafi kaam mein aata hai. Now, what are the advantages of the Elasticsearch is that besides speed, scalability, and resilience, Elasticsearch have several built-in features such as data rollups and index lifecycle management, which makes efficient storing and searching the data very easy. See, there are two things which is very important in case of database management system is that you should be able to store your data, then you should be able to manage your data, and third most important thing is you should be able to search your data. If it is in the organized form, then all these three things becomes easier. That is what the Elasticsearch is known for. Then faster in manner, Elasticsearch excels at full text search, and it is well suited for time sensitive use cases such as security analytics, infrastructure monitoring, etc. So this is the fourth database management system of the machine learning that can be used is Elasticsearch. So ab tak jitne humne char dekhe usme Elasticsearch looks out to be a very good database management system. Then the fifth one is MLDB, that is called as the machine learning database. It is an open source system for solving big data machine learning problems, from data collection, storage through analysis, and training of the machine learning models to deployment of real-time prediction endpoints. So this is by far above all the five. It is a specially database management system which has been applicable for machine learning. It is an open source, so it is going to help in case of data learning problems, data collection, then come storing, then come training. So if you are going to help all these things, five features, then you can be useful in real-time prediction endpoints. That is called as MLDB, machine learning database. In MLDB, machine learning models are applied using functions which are parameterized by output of training procedures which run over data sets containing training data. So you can apply using function. This is the most important thing feature of an MLDB, and therefore which can be the training process can be run over the data sets by using functions. Now, advantage is easy to use. MLDB provides a comprehensive implementation of SQL select statement, training data sets as tables with rows as relations. And this makes the database system easy to learn and use for data analytics familiar with existing relational database management system, jisko hum RDBMS bhi bolte hain. So ye existing RDBMS system ke andar agar aap MLDB use kar sakte ho, तो वो आपको रोज के बीच में रिलेशन देने में भी काम में आएगा, और ओवरऑल इट इज इजियर टू अप्लाई एज वेल एज लर्न एंड गेट द एनालिसिस. सो दिस इज व्हाट द MLDB कैन डू. नाउ सिक्स्थ वन इज अ माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एसक्यूएल सर्वर. सो इट इज रिटन इन सी एंड सी प्लस प्लस. इट इज एन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एसक्यूएल सर्वर is a relational database system, so RDBMS. This database helps in gaining insights from all the data by querying across relational, non-relational, structured as well as unstructured data. So relational, non-relational means the data which you through which you can find a relationship between them. Then non-relational means you cannot find a relationship between that database. And structured and unstructured is that you are having a defined way of putting the data and an undefined way of putting the data. So structured, unstructured, relational, non-relational, these all things can be can be applied through Microsoft SQL Server. So it is going to be applicable to all these four types of datas. Advantages: it is flexible, that is one can use the language and platform of choice and open source support. Then manage big data environment, that is with SQL Server one can manage big data environment more easily with big data clusters. So clusters ke form mein data raha to bhi usko manage kar sakta hai kyunki wo kafi bada hota hai. Agar data bahut zyada bada ho to usko clusters ke form mein divide kiya ja sakta hai. This is also called as a big data clusters. Un cheezon ke liye bhi Microsoft SQL Server kafi kaam mein aata hai. Then it provides a vital element of data lake such as Hadoop distributed file systems, SDFS, then Apache Spark, an analytics tool which is deeply integrated with SQL Server and fully supported by Microsoft. So whatever the names that you have been looking into this, they are completely new for you because they are mostly from the computer related or the information technology related or the computer science or the language related. इसीलिए ये आपको कई नाम इसमें से नए लगेंगे, जैसे हडूप है, जैसे अपाची स्पार्क है. ऑल दिस थिंग्स यू कैन स्टडी इट फ्रॉम द नेट आल्सो. सो दिस इज अबाउट द माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एसक्यूएल सर्वर. Then comes MySQL, which is also one of the most important and popular database management system. Again, written in C and C++. MySQL is again one of the most popular open source relational database management system. So again, ye RDBMS hai aur ye powered by Oracle hai. So this has been this MySQL is been powered by Oracle. That means it has been designed and developed by Oracle. Again, it is an open source relational database management system. It has been used by successful organizations such as Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, among others. So MySQL ke bare mein aapne kafi suna hoga. It is one of the most important database management system aur MySQL mein kafi applications hai. Jaise Facebook, Twitter, YouTube and among others. So in mein sab mein jo database hot manage karte hain, wo MySQL ke through hi karte hain. So what are the advantages? Again, security and scalability. This database management system includes data security layers to protect the sensitive data. It offers scalability to handle large amount of data. So ye dono kaam kar sakta hai. It protects sensitive data, jo bahut kaam ka data hai usko protect karta hai aur bahut zyada data usko handle karta hai. Then second advantage is that backup software. So MySQL dump is a logical backup tool, including with both community and enterprise edition of MySQL. So iska matlab agar aapke data ko backup chahiye to backup jo dene ka kaam karta hai wo MySQL dump naam ke jo concept hai uske through logical backup diya ja sakta hai aur dono kisam ke versions ko diya ja sakta hai. Ek version hai community MySQL aur dusra hai enterprise edition of MySQL. It supports backing up from all the storage engines. So ye sare storage engines ko ke through backup de sakta hai. It supports backing up, and that is through MySQL. So this is also one of the most important open source RDBMS powered by Oracle. Then the eighth one is a MongoDB. It is a general purpose document based distributed database which is built for advanced applications developers. Since this is a document database, it mainly stores data in JSON like documents. It provides supports from aggregation and other modern use cases such as geo based search, graph search and text search. So in cheezon ke liye ye MongoDB jo hai wo use hota hai. Again, it is a document based. This is a somewhat a different database system. It is distributed and built upon an advanced application developer. So ye normal database management system nahi hai. Ye agar jahan par aapko bahut huge amount of data lagta hai aur document based lagta hai to us jagah par ye use kiya ja sakta hai. Ye mostly use kiya ja sakta hai geo based search, graph search aur text search ke liye. What are the advantages? It stores the data in a flexible JSON-like document, which means field can vary from document to document and data structure can be changed over the time. So each jagah par ye MongoDB use kiya ja sakta hai. Then distributed database, it is distributed database as its core, and this is why high availability, horizontal scaling and geographic distributions are built in and easy to use. So this is the eighth type of database management system which we are using. This is like a survey of a database management system that is applicable for machine learning. Ninth one is a PostgreSQL. It is again a powerful open source object relational database system which can use and extend the SQL language combined with many features. So it could be a combination of an SQL plus PostgreSQL. It is used for safely storing and scaling the most complicated data workload. The database management system aims to help developers build applications, administrators to protect data integrity, build fault tolerance environment, and much more. The advantages is PostgreSQL has a robust access control system as well as column and row level security. Extensibility, this system has foreign data wrappers which connect to the other databases or streams with standard SQL interface. So these are some of the advantages of the PostgreSQL, and it is one of the powerful open source object relational database system that can be used and extend the SQL language combined with many features used for scaling as well as storing the complicated data. And the last one is the Redis. It is again an open source in-memory data structure that has been useful for database, cache, and message brokers. Supports data structures like string, sorted set with range queries, bitmaps, hyperlocks, geospatial indices, etc. It has a built-in replications, Lua scripting, LRU evacuation, transaction, and different level of on-disk persistence. The advantages of Redis is automatic failover. In Redis Sentinel, a failover process can be started where replica is promoted to master. इसमें सबसे बात खास बात यह है कि अगर आपका डेटाबेस बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है तो उसका एक रिप्लिका वो बना के रखता है ताकि अगर समटाइम्स ये डेटा लॉस हो जाए तो वो मास्टर से फिर से एक बार रिप्लिका कॉपी कर सकता है. That is the other additional replicas can be reconfigured to use the new master. Redis ML is a Redis module which is implemented in several machine learning models that is built in of Redis data types. It is simple to load and deploy trained models from the platform such as Apache Spark and SKIT Learn. So ये SKIT Learn और Apache Spark ये हम उसमें देखेंगे जब आप practicals वगैरह करेंगे in a production environment. This is about the Redis. So this was for this lecture. Once again, we'll see how many types of database management systems we have seen for machine learning. So obviously, very huge amount of and massive data is there. So we, in order to tackle such kind of massive data, we need database management system. So for that thing, first one was an Apache Cassandra, which is an open source and highly scalable non-SQL database management system, which has been used to manage massive amount of data in a faster manner. So two advantages, fault tolerance and elastic scalability. Second is Couchbase. It is again an open source distributed, no SQL document oriented management system. Then has an advantages of unified programming interface, big data and SQL integration, container and cloud deployment. Then third one is DynamoDB, which is again a fully managed, multi-region durable database, built-in security in backup and restore. Advantages, highly availability and durability, performance at scale. Then comes Elasticsearch, which is used applicable for the data, including textual, numerical, geospatial, structured and unstructured way. It is also useful for data ingestion, enrichment, storage, analysis, and visualization. Advantages, extensive number of features and faster in manner. MLDB, which is called as Machine Learning Database Management System, which is very much useful for data collection and storage through analysis, as well as training of the machine learning models, and hence can be applied in real-time predictions. Advantages, easy to use. It is actually very much similar or familiar with existing relational database management system. Microsoft SQL Server, again, it is RDBMS, been applied for the relational, non-relational, structural, as well as unstructured data. Advantages, flexible, used to manage big data environment, and provides vital element for the data lake such as Hadoop distributed file systems, Apache Sparks, and analytical tools. MySQL, one of the most written in C and C++, one of the most popular open source RDMS data powered by Oracle, mostly used by the organizations such as Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, amongst the others. Advantages, security and scalability, and this backup software. MongoDB, again a general purpose document based distributed database system, most advanced application developers, and it supports the database which include geo-based search, graph search and text search. Advantages, data store flexibility and distributed database. PostgreSQL is again one of the most open source object relational database management system, useful for data integrity, build fault tolerant environment systems, and much more. Advantages, security, and extensibility. And Redis, which is the last one, is an open source in-memory data structure store used in database cache and message brokers. It has been used for the data structures like string, sorted sets, and range queries, bitmaps, hyperlogs, geospatial indices. And the advantages is automatic failover and Redis ML. So this is what we have seen. Yes, any questions, please, students?
No, sir.
हाँ ये नया था बिल्कुल आपके लिए ये मेरे लिए भी नया था बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द वर्ड्स दैट आर बीन यूज्ड हियर इज रिलेटेड विद द प्रोग्रामिंग लाइक जावा इट माइट बी लाइक सी सी प्लस प्लस सी स्मार्ट सी हैश एंड लॉट ऑफ न्यू लैंग्वेजेस दैट इज बीन कमिंग अप सो दीज ऑल वर्ड्स दैट इज कमिंग थ्रू विच आर न्यू टू यू ऑल्सो एंड न्यू टू मी ऑल्सो बिकॉज दिस सब्जेक्ट इज न्यू So as far as you keep on studying, you'll definitely come to know about all these things. Okay, so we'll go to the attendance once a minute. 1 minute, please.
Excuse me, sir.
Huh?
So can you share the PPTs on group?
Yes. We are going to share the PPTs definitely. These PPTs I will have it on a Google Drive, and then from Google Drive I will give you the link also for that. Okay. So, what I'll do is that tomorrow I will be getting the time. So, जो चार यूनिट का है नहीं तो फिर क्या करेंगे एक यूनिट के अभी सात से आठ लेक्चर्स हो जाएंगे तो उसके साथ में फिर मैं आपको वो पूरे के पूरे आठ PPTs एक साथ शेयर करूंगा चलेगा ना
Okay, sir.
हाँ, no problem at all. Okay.